You have to stop thinking in terms of what you've done before or what's been possible in the past or even what other people have done. If you're going to look at what other people have done, look at them only for inspiration to see what's possible for you too. Hello, my loves. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, I'm Leora Alexandra. Welcome to the Bee community. On this channel, we talk about the law of attraction, spirituality, self-development, and so much more. And it's been a while since I've done one of these videos, but it is a topic that I'm passionate about and that I've done since the beginning of this channel. So I want to just put a little note. So we're talking today about how to use your mind to change your body. And when I say that, I don't necessarily mean only for aesthetic purposes or only to look like what society thinks we should look like, because that's not what I'm about. What I am about is aesthetic beauty when it comes to ourselves, our individual expression of beauty, and what that means to us, how we like to be aesthetically pleasing for ourselves, for the people in our lives. But it's also about healing. It's also about taking care of your body, about having a body that works well, that functions well, right? So today's video is not just a shallow, like, here's how to look like a Kardashian. It's nothing like that. It's more how to look and feel your best and also be at your optimal well-being, at your best possible health, because you deserve that. You came here in a body. You deserve to take care of this body like the temple that it is. You deserve to feel good. You deserve to have every part of your body functioning like a well-oiled machine. Working with the mind is such a big part of that. So when I talk about changing your body, this could mean to heal your body, to change the way that you look, to gain or drop weight, whatever it is that you really desire, you know, to heal some sort of illness or malady. Can it make you get taller? I don't know. I personally haven't tried it. But if you're into that, please report back, okay? As far as I'm concerned, every possibility exists and we can align to every single possibility out there if we want it badly enough. So yeah, so today we're gonna talk about how we can do that. But before we get started, I want to give a big shout out to one of my favorites, one of your favorites too, which is Skillshare, who's the lovely sponsor of today's video. If you're not already familiar, Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for lifelong learners like me, like you. So one of my favorite Skillshare classes is one that I've revisited to get myself back on track lately, and that is called Productivity for Creatives. Build a system that brings out your best. I know as a creative person, and my other creatives out there will tell you that, you know, being creative is the easy part, but what about everything else? How do you monetize it? How do you stay on track? How do you complete projects? And this class is so helpful for that. So I've been feeling really short on ideas lately, and I went and revisited this class, and right after I wrote 4 scripts, this video being one of those scripts, because it really gave me the reminders, the tips, and the resources that I needed to recreate my game plan when it comes to my work. I've also taken meditation, journaling, interior design, audio engineering, productivity classes, and even classes on real estate and investment on Skillshare. And I've walked away from each one of these short classes, usually in under 60 minutes, with a new understanding of a new skill or a new hobby. There are no ads on Skillshare because it's curated specifically for learning, and they're always adding new premium classes. And now they have subtitles in Spanish, French, Portuguese, and Dutch. And now, because Skillshare is sponsoring today's video, the first 1,000 of my viewers to click the link below will get a free 1-month trial of their premium membership so you can explore your creativity. Thank you, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. So let's get into my tips for how to use your mind to change your body. And of course, this could apply to anything that you're manifesting, right? But I know that there's so many of us right now who just want a little bit of healing. I had to use these techniques in the last 2 months because I think I mentioned it before that during the panini, I put on about 10 to 15 pounds. I didn't realize I was doing it, but it just happened little by little, and I was able to drop them in the last 2 months. And I used all of these tips that I'm going to offer you today. And I've done something that I've never done before. I've never done sustainable weight loss like that. The only other time I've ever lost a significant amount of weight in my life was when I went vegan and completely changed my lifestyle. So these past 2 months, of course, I again completely changed my lifestyle, but more so with my mind and how I look at the potentialities in my life. So let's get into it. My first bit of advice, which is something that I used a lot and that really, really helped me, is to continuously remind yourself that anything is possible. Remember that your past doesn't determine your future. For example, we all thought life would be one way in February of 2020, and by the next month, everything had been turned upside down for every single person living on this planet as we, you know, experienced a huge world event that flipped everything upside down. No one could have predicted that, except for the people who maybe engineered it. Nothing is ever promised to remain the same. This is the quantum realm. This is how quantum physics works. All things are possible. Remind yourself that there's just as much probability of you achieving something as there is of you not achieving it. And it's all about where you're going to put your faith and where you're going to put your attention. So what I do is I just continuously tell myself, like, what I want is possible. It might seem impossible because I've never had it before, but the health and the fitness level of where I want to be is possible. I've seen other people do it. I've seen examples of it, and I know I can do it. I can visualize it and I can do it. Number two, it coincides with this, is to not let other people's limiting beliefs about themselves affect you or stop you or even slow you down. We have to recognize other people's stories as their limiting beliefs. They're choosing these beliefs. They're choosing to have faith in these things. And you gotta keep bringing yourself back to the story that you are choosing. For example, one of my friends, you know, she has all the positive intentions for me in the world, but she really showed her limiting beliefs when she said to me that at one point in my weight loss journey, I will hit a plateau and that I won't be able to lose weight as quickly anymore. So at first I found myself getting worried and upset, but I quickly realized that this is just a story that she's experienced because of her own life experiences. And she is trying to share that story with me because it's going to validate her own experience, right? But all she's sharing with me is a thought. It's not an objective reality for me. So I decided that I was not plateauing, and since we had that conversation, I dropped 3 more pounds and 2 more inches since she claimed that I was probably plateauing, and it was easy. The third is so powerful, okay? I found it to be really powerful to visualize other people's reactions to me. So I would visualize how I would be complimented on my weight loss and how my friends and family would be proud of me, and I would really visualize and feel what they would actually say when they saw the progress I was making. So I'd imagine them saying it, and then I'd let myself feel that pride and that happiness that I would feel when I actually heard these things. Of course, as always, in my physical actual reality, all the people that I imagined complimenting me and making comments about my progress actually came to fruition. So that happened. So visualize it, imagine it, see your best friend or your mom or your partner or a coworker mentioning that, you know, whatever it is that you're trying to manifest. Oh, you look so healthy, you're glowing, you're this, you're that. You're going to see that actually happen in your reality. And when you're imagining these things and feeling those thoughts, because the feeling is a secret as always, and if any doubt creeps in, remind yourself of what we just talked about, right? That anything is possible. You get to choose which anything you put your faith in. Number four, this was really helpful for me, especially if you're trying to really change your physical body. And this can also be helpful if you're trying to heal something. So I used to do this when I had Bell's palsy. You guys might remember I did some videos about my healing journey with that. I would meditate and I would imagine this side of my face. I would imagine the muscles, the nerves and everything just being filled with white light and getting healing, receiving healing every time I sat down for meditation and hypnotherapy. So I do the same thing now as I work out. I imagine the muscle group that I'm exercising and how I wanted to grow and get stronger. For example, like your booty muscles or something, as you're doing your exercises and your reps, you're kind of visualizing it. So what I found to be really helpful is to get a little bit of a better understanding of the human anatomy and to know which muscle groups you're using and what they're capable of. And then imagine that muscle group moving and doing exactly what you wanted to do as you're exercising it, or even as you're taking a walk. As I walk, I imagine which muscle group is being worked. Even something as low impact as walking has really changed my body and changed my health and changed my mindset as well. You might be familiar with Dr. Joe Dispenza. He healed his horrible back issues by continuously visualizing and meditating on that area of his body and seeing it being healed. So this works. Number five, this one is specific to me. This is what I use, but it works. And I know I always recommend this for all the different things in life, but that's because it really works and helps in every area of our lives. And that is hypnotherapy. Get a hypnotherapy session and have the hypnotist add suggestions that align with what you want. 10 weeks ago, I did a self-hypnosis session on myself where I made all sorts of suggestions. And one of the suggestions that I made was that I was able to drop 10 pounds in a healthy and sustainable way. And today, as I am recording this, I have officially reached that goal and I'm really proud of myself. I'd never before really been able to stick to sustainable weight loss. I always just kind of went up and down according to how physical and active I was in that particular moment in my life, or how much I was eating or not eating, forgetting to eat. Now I don't restrict myself. I don't do anything. I'm just moving in a way that I love to do because I hypnotized myself to love to do it. And I'm making better decisions, and I was able to drop the weight so easily. A hypnotherapy session will help to embed deep beliefs inside of you that you are able to do what it is that you're trying to do. And you can also, you know, you could hypnotize yourself. You can get a hypnotherapy appointment, or you can also go on YouTube and search in. A lot of hypnotists offer specific hypnotherapy meditations on YouTube for free. And the sixth tip I have is patience, self-love, and gratitude. So one of the things that would get the most in my way when I was younger and trying to make any sort of physical changes in myself is that I would get frustrated when I didn't see results soon enough. I would be hard on myself and I would kind of give up because I'm like, oh, I've been doing this for a week and nothing's changed. This is the first time where I've been so patient with myself, knowing that, okay, I might not see any difference the first week or the second week, but by the third week, there's gonna be a little difference. And if I just keep going, let's see where I'm gonna be in a month from now, and then 2 months from now, and 3 months from now. And looking back, it's the best decision I've ever made. So having that patience with yourself and seeing that this is a journey and it's a spiritual experience within itself, that it's me and my body getting to the healthiest, fittest, best shape that we possibly can, me and my body connecting and learning about one another, that's a spiritual experience. And that's when I was able to slow down and feel every day and just experience every moment of the journey for what it was. So when I somehow 1 week gained 4 pounds again overnight, it seemed like, instead of giving up, I was easy on myself and I was like, it's fine, let's just keep going. I got this, I know what I'm doing, I'm equipped for this, let's just keep going. So it's that patience, okay? And then that's when I also stopped being so hard on myself and on my health and on my body. I decided that this was a journey and I'm gonna appreciate every moment of it. And what changed is that it stopped being a crash diet. It stopped being, you know, thinking that I needed to starve myself or be a quick fix, and it became a lifestyle. It took me about 6 weeks to get really comfortable with being slow and patient with myself, but I saw the results in my physical and mental health little by little and then all at once. And the self-love part is giving myself a lot of love, especially any part of myself that I used to criticize or want to change and be hard on myself for. I soaked that part of me and all of me with this beautiful, unconditional love and acceptance. Like, I love you. You're perfect the way you are. Thank you for everything that you do for me already. I'm already grateful for everything that you are. I stopped bullying myself and that changed everything. And it's like, this is a journey, right? We're gonna go through a self-love journey. There's ups and downs, the healing, there's ups and downs. You can go for months with self-love and just accepting every cute little thing and every little mistake and imperfection you have, and then hate yourself for a week. And that's okay, because you're gonna come right back to that self-love. As long as you don't get stuck in a cycle of hate, hatred toward yourself and confusion, forgetting what you really are and how beautiful you really are, you can just come right back to that place of self-love. So when I received compliments also from other people, I allowed myself to be loved. And so instead of denying them, I just accepted and I learned to receive and just, you know, give a warm thank you. And gratitude, of course, like I was saying, is gratitude for what we already have, what our bodies are able to do for us, what our health does give us, how we get up every morning, how we carry ourselves every day throughout this world. There's a lot of potential in gratitude. In gratitude is where everything that we desire lies, in that frequency of gratitude. So just being grateful for the journey, being grateful for your ability to even focus on healing yourself and getting back to a good place. That will get you exactly where you are meant to be. So those are my tips about how to take care of your body with your mind, how to heal your body with your mind, how to change your body with your mind. If you have any that you are interested in sharing with the community, I encourage you to comment it down below. It's gonna help somebody scrolling through the comments so much. I'm also curious to know which of these tips you liked the best. If you can comment that below too, which ones you're going to take into your own journey. Kind of so I know I can gauge what we liked and what we didn't like. All right, I love you so much. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to support the channel, please click the link below for Skillshare. Get yourself a free 1 month trial. Try out that class about productivity for creatives. It's super good. I'm actually going to keep watching it tonight for the second time. So yeah, I love you so much. Until next time, keep your vibration way, way, way up.